Hey, hi everyone. Welcome to the Selenium Python tutorial. I'm Aditya from Specialized Automations. So in this video, we'll be specifically looking into how we can pass the application output in Python terminal or against the Python console. Okay. So for my case, I'm using Selenium. So I'll be automating some web browser using the Selenium, and already I've created a few test script, and I want to generate all this test script output in my Python terminal. Okay. So let's get started. So this is my script folder containing all my test scripts. Skip the demo. This is my first unit test that I have already discussed in my earlier video, and all this test design using the pytest. So as of now, that I have already told, the Python having three types of unit testing framework. One is nose you can use, another is pyunit, that's come from the inbuilt unit testing framework. Another thing, important part, pytest unit testing framework can also use. For my case, I'm using the inbuilt unit testing framework along with the pytest. Okay. So suppose this is my pytest unit testing framework. Okay. So what basically is doing? It's extending my environment setup classes, navigating to the particular website. All these things has been discussed in my base classes. And how to design base classes, I've already provided a separate tutorial for that. So my this test script basically calling my base classes, navigating to the website, then validating, asserting the expected title, printing all the contents and all the reference link, everything, just normal simple test script should have. Okay, so if I run my home page, this test script, let's see. So Chrome browser successfully opened and closed. Okay, that's great. So guys, we have seen that all these things getting printed, web page loaded successfully, marker logo, and all the link that has been asserted during this test validations. Now if you want to run this pytest from our console, let's run cmd. Okay, let me show you, like, if you want to run all these three program using pytest, I can do that. And to copy the path where the file may locate it, cd, and then if I want to run all these things, suppose this test, three test script I want to run, so all these three test scripts will get run. Let me show if there is the application output we are getting or not. So simultaneously three working node is operating. Okay. Okay. So it's showing three test passed in 44.83 seconds, but we are not getting any kind of output in my Python terminal. Okay. So how do I get it? So for that case, there's a lots of discussion is going over than currently going over or going on. So if you are using the Python versions later than 3, like for my case, let me show you the Python versions. I'm currently using the Python version 3.6.3. So the before 3, the Python versions, what you need to do, you need to use one init Python, okay, that blank file, and sometimes you need to provide all the importings part, like so init.py you need to mentions in your directory. So that you can call and import all these modules, okay? Like, let me show you. If I run this way, three errors. Let me scroll this and show you the error. It's showing module not found, no module web automations. Okay, then it's showing no module not found error, no module in web automations. So it's simply not able to find my script, all this test script that is located in my web automations directory. Also, get for as a solutions, we need to use that init.python. This is a Python file we need to use for each and every directory so that we can successfully import this directory, okay, and use the directory. But later for the Python versions after three versions, so what we need to do, we don't need to do include any Python init Python file, just we need to mention the Python, set the Python path to the root directory, okay. So let's run. For Windows I'll be using this. So first we need to set the Python path, so it will considering from the root directory, okay. Then we will run our same test, pytest -s for which will capture all the relevant screen, I mean application output. Now if you run this program, so it's showing, now we can see, okay, so now we can see all my three browser will be launched and my test script is validation is in progress. And if I check my console window, I am seeing all these things is successfully getting printed. Okay, meanwhile I will highly recommend to navigate to a website like pytest.org and see the basic uses and invocations. We can also launch the pytest from the Python interpreter, okay, by following these commands and all the possible exit code, six types of exit code you will get, along with all the commands like how you can pass specify test, run your test from a particular module directory, okay, all these things you will get. So use the PI website for more informations, and capturing relevant the screen of the standard input output, you can also have like three ways you can influence this: pytest_s, capture system, or capture FD, okay. That's it. Let's give it some time to complete the. Okay. So now let's look into the output. Whatever the output you have got. So my test session has been started along with this printing Chrome environment setup. This is executing my first test. Okay. Marketing tools homepage. Now it's executing my marketing tools registration page, then executing my marketing tools sign on page, okay, and now it's completed three tests passing 83.10 seconds. So it's done basically in sequential order. So the main difference is that initially I was not getting any kind of log, application log in my console output, okay. It was showing like ... Right now I'm getting all this application log in my console. So what we need to do, if you are using PyTest unit testing framework, just set the Python path to ., which will indicate the root folder, and then you will pass your PyTest command to execute your test script. You can pass multiple script, you can do parallel executions, and you can do pass one single test Python file also in that way, okay. So these things keep in mind, that using set Python path to the root, and then whatever you do, Python -s, s will take the screenshot. It will capture all the relevant screenshot, okay. So this is how you can get your all the screen application output to your console. So another important thing is that, like, this is for my test script, okay, that is self itself containing the setup method, teardown method, it's him navigating to the Mercury website and printing its titles. If I just execute it, like we'll be executing it using the pytest myunit_test.py, and the path already have been given, okay. So simply execute this. It will load the website. So one passed in 22 seconds, but it's not printing anything, okay. But if you simply run this command, like pytest my first, test.py -s, okay. Now we'll see. It's navigating to the website, okay, and see the difference. I mean, in my earlier cases, it was not printing anything. Now when I'm providing hyphen s, and it's printing all the things like testament created, run started, welcome market tools and testament tested, all the things. Okay,
so that's all for today, guys. If you have any questions, please do let me know in the below comment sections. And if you like this video, please do not forget to support and subscribe my channel. Okay, so have a good day, everyone. Bye bye.